The Legend of Zelda series is filled to the brim with all kinds of mysterious stories and legends, big and small. Now, some of these actually happened, like how Ganondorf attacked Hyrule before the Wind Waker, which led to the flooding of the entire land. However, there are also stories going around in the community that are a bit less factual. They're more like urban legends. Certain things that you can do according to some, from simple things like places you can go to, and bigger ones like whole side quests. And today we'll be looking at one thing from probably the most well-known Zelda game, Ocarina of Time. Because there is something in Zora's Domain, according to some, that almost no one has ever seen, and leads to a special place. First up, we need to take a look at Zora's Domain, to know what happened there and what you can do. Context is important. It's located in the northeast section of Hyrule and is home to King Zora and his daughter, Princess Ruto. It consists of a large, cavernous area, mostly filled with water, with a large waterfall flowing from the top into the lower area. Its source of water comes from Zora's fountain, to which it's closely linked to. Now, your first visit to the domain happens during your search for the third spiritual stone, the Zora Sapphire. However, when you come back later on as adult, a lot has changed in those long 7 years. It completely turned into ice. All the water found is frozen, and the same goes for the Zora and their beloved king. In the end, you solve this by going to the water temple and beating the evil found within called Morpha. After that, it all turns back to normal. However, during this section, you can see something which might have had an impact on the game at some point. There is a hole that can be found under the frozen ice in Zora's Domain, which many believe was originally a passage to the Unicorn Fountain.
Now, it could have been there, but if it was, the coding to transport Link to it has been removed. Alright, some of you might think at this point, what in Hylia's name is the Unicorn Fountain? I've never heard about that. Well, let us explain. During the development of Ocarina of Time, the Great Fairies were not the same ones that appeared in the final version of the game, for they had more of a crystal appearance with long white wings. Their crystalline appearance is similar to that of the Great Fairies from the Wind Waker. The early Great Fairy surprisingly shares the same model file as the in-game Great Fairy. However, they didn't only work on the beings found within it, but also the locations where they are found. Because the Unicorn Fountain is an area resembling a fairy fountain containing a statue of a unicorn's head. It can be seen in pre-release material, and this location doesn't exist in the final game that we all know and love. However, there are still a ton of people who actually believe that this place is in the game and was supposed to be in Zora's Domain. So let's look into this a bit and find out what its purpose could have been and if it really was in the home of the Zoras. Let's start with our first question. What exactly is it? Well, when looking at recreations of the old place and old demo footage, we can see it's quite different from normal fairy fountains. It has a water fountain in the middle with statues around it. Besides that, no pedestal for playing songs or great fairies are seen. So by the looks of it, it had a completely different purpose than the normal ones, and the only thing that seems to make sense is something related to horses. It's completely unicorn themed after all, and Link's horse Epona was introduced in this game and used a lot. So maybe you could get a certain special or interesting item from here. Maybe even learn how to ride a horse from a god specialized in it. They did something similar to it in Breath of the Wild, where there is a special fountain where a horse god is residing. So maybe that was supposed to be the case with this one as well. But in the end, they made it more simplistic. There were some things cut out after all because of the time constraints, like the Wind Temple, which never made it in.
Now for our second question. Was it really planned to be somewhere in Zora's Domain? Well, if we would keep my idea in mind, then no. It's surrounded by water, so why would a fairy fountain for a horse god be there? But if this isn't the case, then it could make sense, because there is more to do than just the water temple. When you arrive in the adult era, the only Zoras that are found are the king and the shopkeeper, and both of them are frozen over by red ice, which only blue fire can melt. In game, you get this from the ice cavern, where you also learn the song to get inside the temple itself. But maybe this unused fountain that many believe to be real was actually where he got the blue fire from, or even the song. This could make sense. However, we aren't sure when Nintendo exactly made the ice cavern and the unicorn fountain. So we can't be sure about it, but it certainly looks like there used to be something in the water there. And getting to it would also work. They could have used red ice to block it off, so you can only go to it after you obtain blue fire. However, in the end they didn't put it in. And clipping through the ground to get to it won't yield any results. So it's certainly a fake entrance, and there is nothing there. Even out of bounds, nothing can be found. So we will never know where this mysterious fountain was supposed to be and what its role was. But at least, the mystery is solved and the myth is debunked. Well, it tried so hard and got so far, but in the end, there's at least videos about it, so thank you for watching. You already know the rest of the lines.